So we have to prove these two results here, where the second one is in terms of something called the Dawson integral, which is defined like that. And we're told basically how we can do it. This is rather difficult to guess otherwise. So it's suggested that we use the following contour, a rectangular contour, this time going from the origin, the height of the contour is lambda. So it's distance lambda. Okay, and it's suggested that we take the limit as r goes to infinity and integrate just simply e to the minus z squared around this contour. Now, obviously, e to the minus z squared has no singularities as long as r is finite. So there's no poles inside the contour. So this is going to equal zero. We just need to work out what we actually get when we integrate these things, this thing around this contour. So first integral is going to be from zero, is going to be along here, z is equal to x. So it's just e to the minus x squared. From 0 to infinity. Now this is a well-known integral which has a value of root pi by 2. This should be in your formula sheets. Then the next integral along here, we would probably guess that this is going to vanish. It's this sort of integral which is likely to vanish, we hope. So y is going from 0 to lambda. We've got e to the minus r plus I y squared, and dz is I dy, and basically as r goes to infinity, this clearly is going to go to zero. Y is just a positive number, which is, just goes up to lambda. So this is going to basically go off like e to the minus r squared, which goes to zero. Then the next bit is the integral along here. So we can go ahead and take the limit as r goes to infinity and x varies from infinity to zero. And here we have z equals x plus I lambda along here. So z equals x plus I lambda. So when we square it and do a minus sign, what do we end up with? So we end up with minus x squared minus 2 I x lambda, and then this squared gives us with a minus sign at plus lambda squared. And finally we've got the integral down here. It's the integral from lambda to zero of y is just equal to z is equal to I lambda along here. Z is equal to I y along here, and y varies from lambda to zero. So we end up with e to the, when I square this, I get plus y squared. So I get e to the y squared dy. So as we said, all of this is equal to 2 pi I times the sum of the residues, but there's the sum of the residues is zero, so all of these expressions overall give us zero. So we just need to see what we've got in the end. So We've got this plus this plus this equals zero. So rewriting, we've got this, as we said, is root pi over 2. This, we can take out the fact of e to the lambda squared. So we've got, and we've also got, we can get, well, okay, let's shift things onto the other side. So we've got, this is going on to the other side, which we use to swap the limits. So we've got e to the x squared. So this is looking like the thing we actually want to evaluate. So we've got a factor of e to the lambda squared, which we can take out the front. And then we've got the integral from 0 to infinity, because we reversed this. And we've got, what do we have left? We've got e to the minus x squared. And then using Euler on this, we've got cos of 2 lambda x plus I times sine of 2 lambda x dx. Okay, so that's this integral here. And then we also have this integral here. I've forgotten a factor of I. Dz is I dy, so I forgot this factor of I here. So then we end up with I times the integral from 0 to lambda of e to the y squared dy. Now all we need to do is take real and imaginary parts. So taking the real part, we end up real parts of this expression, and dividing by e, okay, well, I'll just do it slowly. We'll end up with e to the lambda squared times the integral from 0 to infinity of e to the minus x squared cos 2 lambda x dx is equal to root pi over 2. So that's the real part gives me that. And then you can see I can just divide this by e to the lambda squared, and I end up with the first expression. Sorry, this should have been a minus sign here, because I had e to the minus 2 lambda ix. Okay, so then I can take the imaginary part, and I get zero on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side I get minus, so I just get this thing here. So I get e to the lambda squared 0 to infinity e to the minus x squared sine 2 lambda x dx, and then the imaginary part just gives me this. Then I can move this onto this side and divide through by e to the lambda squared, and I end up with, let's just call this is, and we get is is equal to e to the minus lambda squared times 0 to the lambda e to the y squared dy. And looking, comparing the definition, instead of x I've got lambda, so this is simply the Dawson integral of lambda, which is what I wanted to prove.